Nobody's perfect. I am perfect. You're not perfect. None of us are perfect. But I'm just saying that a man is judged by his intentions. A man is judged by his drive.
So far, so good. We're still living today. But we don't know what tomorrow brings in this crazy world.
My name is Kwame Lekwa. And you're here with Ashan TV. Subscribe to this channel if you're new here. Ashan, we have a motto, and our motto is we are killing two birds with one stone, meaning we will get into so many different varieties of programs and topics and all other angles. But our focus or our whole purpose is the African community. So if you haven't watched my videos, you can go back and watch some of my videos. You will see my intentions anyway. So today I'm here to talk about my view on Nana Akufo-Addo as a president of Ghana. My view. Everybody has a view on the man, but I have my view. But let me put this out there. Even though I was born in Kumasi and raised as an MPP, I'm not doing this as an MPP or NDC or any party member. It's just an individual person as Nana Akufo-Addo that I'm actually singling out and going to talk about him, what I think about him. I met the man two times. The first one was more like accidental. I happened to be in Ghana. I was at Accra Mall. I met with one of my old friends, also the Empire, who is still an MPP member today. I met him, it was Nana Akufo-Addo's birthday. He was going to see Nana Akufo-Addo. Because I had nothing to do that day, you know what, let's go. So that was the first time I met Nana Akufo-Addo. It was his birthday, shook his hands, met his wife. I don't know if you can remember, because I'm sure they see a whole lot of people, so I'm not saying they should. But I'm just saying my encounter. The second one was also in London, Manchester. I have actually finished my property exhibition and he has also finished his conference. Bumping into each other at the train station. I think he was seeing people off and I was actually coming to board the train. So that's when I approached him, we had a conversation. But what he said to me is what I want us to focus, because that's my focal point. He asked me what I do for a living, and of course, I work as an estate agent, which I help the African community in East London, especially the Ghanaian community. Especially, you know, it's like I'm Ghanaian, they're Ghanaian, they're looking for property, they gravitate towards me, and I also try and assist them. So, hey, I told the man, and he said to me, you are one of these people that we need in Ghana in order to help Ghana rebuild, because everybody can play their part, because the youth need you. My name is Kwan Lekwa. And you're here with Ashan TV.
Down, four, same thing. But with him, when he lost for almost about two times of becoming the president, he never gave up. But the thing is, I don't think it began from there. I think it began from way far for him to drive himself all the way to that seat and lost two times and still came back and won. And that's the motivation too for me, because in the business world, that's what it is. You know, you go through all this hassle and tussle, and then the strongest survives. So that is the direction I'm actually coming from, like using the Akufo-Addo as a tool. And I think we should learn to celebrate people once they're alive. We shouldn't wait for them to die before we celebrate them anyway. So, and that's my view, right? But anyway, so me being in Ghana now, I can understand from where he's coming from, because I have made it upon myself to interact with the people since I've been in Ghana. When I sit in the taxi, when I sit in the Uber, I chat to the people, you can see that we have some intelligent people. All they need is just an opportunity. All they need is just somebody to say they can do it. And the thing is, there's a lot of opportunities hooving around them. But it's just that somebody need to point them to that right direction. So he was right when he said that some of us, like you, for instance, if all of us are going to stay in abroad without looking back, nobody can play their part. I'm just going to end this here and to say that let me know what you think about this thing, you know, saying that Nana Akufo-Addo is a motivation. I'm not saying he's perfect. Nobody's perfect. I am perfect. You're not perfect. None of us are perfect. But I'm just saying that a man is judged by his intentions, a man by his tribe. Let me say this in quotes. He said that he was actually coming to give Ghana free education. That's from way back, his idea was way back, because I remember other opposition parties went on saying that, oh, he can't bring that about. You can't do that. You can't create free education system in the country. We're not ready yet. But he's managed to implement that, even though he gave us a lot of promises, and he hasn't been able to fulfill all the promises, which I know that the COVID-19 can become a very good excuse or escape for him, because then that has actually brought everything, and because of COVID-19, he couldn't finish whatever. But at the end of the day, what if it wasn't for the COVID? Maybe he could have also been able to do the rest of the stuff that he is said to be. He's still in power, so let's see what he's doing. It's just that I want us to look at the positive side of Nana Akufo-Addo as him being a motivation to the youth and to me and to you. We're not gonna give up. Even when we're down, we're gonna press on. When it's difficult, we're gonna strap it on, like Nana Akufo-Addo. Thank you. Catch you on the next one.
People dying like flies every day. You read about it in the news, but you don't.